Submission Collision.
You ready? You ready?
Fight! All right, so lofty expectations for this matchup as round one gets underway. It seems to be a strength advantage by one side. Just out of range with the straight left. Oh! Try to hip escape. Nicely done there as he forces the miss from his opponent. Oh, he postured up there, gained some valuable separation.
And now the ground and pound starts.
Oh man, this ground and pound is good. Probably my favorite striking realm in MMA, and he's as good as it gets. Over 3 minutes now to go in round two. defensively to raise the guard and prevent any damage.
He needs to start looking to finish.
Continues to be attacked by the opponent. If this thing gets any worse, they're gonna see.
You ready? Fight.
Third round underway. Well, most fighters can't keep up this type of aggression and pace, but you don't have to worry about this guy. He hasn't really shown any signs of slowing down tonight. Trying to establish that jab once again. Well, he continues to do a nice job here defensively, protecting his head, raising.
Oh! He's hurt bad. He's got a pressure. He's got to go chase that finish down.
Strong outside leg kick there.
Big right
hook there. Both guys
in. Oh!
In a pretty good position to get out, I would think, if he so chooses.
Absolutely. This is the ideal position for escaping. Now, you're not going to get a submission off or anything like that, but you having your feet on your opponent's hips, it just allows you to build a push. You just push with your feet and elevate your opponent's hips away from you.
To like over the distance of that fight tonight. Clearly, we think we saw one guy win the fight and largely got it done with the strike.
Yeah, he got it done with the strike. And that's exactly what he's known for. He's known as a guy that's so comfortable whenever he's in the stand-up. And that showed tonight as he truly outworked his opponent.
Ladies and gentlemen, after three rounds, we go to the judges' scorecards for decision. All three judges score the contest. 29-28. declaring the winner by unanimous decision, Cyril Mangamaga.
All right, coming up next, it's a UFC heavyweight showdown.
Ready? You ready to fight?
All right, so here we are from Newark, New Jersey at the Prudential Center. Sellout crowd expected here tonight, all to witness more UFC history. This venue's been good to the UFC in the past. Hopefully plenty more where that came from.
In New Jersey, you better be ready to put on the show. Because these fans understand what they're watching and they've been around since day one. They know a good fight when they see it. And if you start trying to hold and hug inside the octagon, be ready for the boo burst to come up. Big punch lands over the top. How's he gonna follow this one?
Well, perhaps a sign of things to come as he lands a kick there.
Nice kick.
Still stand.
I mean, this guy's chin is made of granite. In order to take a punch like that, friends, you got it. One of the tallest guys I've ever seen step into the UFC office.
He's already landed several in the round. That one might have been the cleanest of the match.
He turned his chin, made his chin touch his shoulder with that beautiful hook. He really got all of himself into that hook. Pivoted off the right hand, big left hook lands. What a great punch.
Oh, and he connects with a punch there, DC. You like this guy.
I like this guy a ton. And to watch him punch like this is all of my favorite.
That kick brought by the Predator, Francis Ngannou.
Check.
Under 2 minutes in the first round. Straight right is there. Try to establish that jab.
Let's go. Set up that takedown.
Much improved defensively as he blocks the shot. So just over 20 total strikes have landed for Francis Ngannou. He gets tagged. Beautiful combination there. And I'm not sure how many more of those power shots he can take.
The night is almost over. If you keep getting hit with punches like this, you are going to sleep.
Ooh, and he caught the kick. Oh, that is exactly how he turned defense into offense. Catches the kick and dumps him on the mat.
What a great job timing that kick, driving into his opponent and putting him on his back. Big punch man. Now we get back to range. That is, oh man, this dude is good.
Okay, breathe. Breathe. Relax. All right, second round is underway. Your thoughts on what we saw over the first 5 minutes?
I saw a very competitive round, very strategic. Where they don't feel like they can ever miss that shot.
Stuff the takedown, no problem. Now he engages in a Muay Thai clinch. You better protect that head.
Great job securing the Muay Thai clinch. Watch for big knees to the body, and eventually him switch it up with a big knee to the head.
Well done. Oh, there he is. Catches the kick there. Beautifully catches with the takedown. So a nice job turning that defense into some immediate offense there.
He did a great job of turning it.
Good a one-strike finish as we've seen here in the UFC in recent memory. I'm not even sure the opponent saw it coming. So big, big win for him here tonight. Well, he's going to enjoy watching this one back. Let's take a look at the replay of the knockout just a moment.
It was right hand after right hand after right hand. Finally, he found the one that hit the exact switch.
All right, coming up next, it's a heavyweight collision between Alistair Overeem and the Black Beast, Derek Lewis.
You ready? Let's go fight.
The tension is palpable as this fight gets underway, and it'll be interesting to see how this matchup plays out. Definite striker on one side against another guy who can really do it all.
And in those situations, normally the guy that's more well-rounded will be the one that will find success. I want to see how this plays out.
Well, perhaps a sign of things to come if he lands a kick there.
Nice kick landed by the jump.
Whiffs on the elbow. Man, he is so sound defensively. Nice job to raise the guard there.
It's the relaxation that allows him to see things coming and block most of the strikes that are from that.
Overeem gets caught with that punch. Not the easiest guy in the world to hit, but he got caught there. Able to land with that punch.
I mean, he's cutting down the size with these beautiful leg kicks.
Oh, yeah. Just over 2 minutes now to go. And he connects with a punch there. We'll see if he can follow it up.
He's landed that punch over and over again. What's he going to do to follow up?
There with the left.
Let's get some offense. Let's get going.
Well, he's doing a nice job here blocking these shots. The chin is tucked. The hands are high. Pretty good job defensively thus far.
Great job defensively. He's seeing everything coming.
So just over 20 total strikes have now found the target for Alistair Overeem. He's able to slip the left. Just out of range with that punch attempt.
Oh, nice move.
Keep moving. Move your head. Oh, good left hook there. Whiffs off the straight right hand.
Nice. Nice.
Well, he's always on the counterattack, but a nice leg kick there by the Black Beast. All right, there's the clapper. 10 seconds to go. That's a beautiful kick right there.
Looks like he's going to be kicked
by a rule. Probably feels something like that.
It has to. This guy is landing his kick.
All right, second round now underway.
Okay,
I'm going to
round two.
A little bit of a feeling out process there.
Let's go fight.
That's a part of being in the octagon with someone that's so skilled. You cannot just go after a gun to play. Most of the time, I'm trying to find the right moment. He's throwing every part of himself into this big leg kick.
just misses. Expectations here as
so, guys, fight.
I expect the action to really pick up now. These guys have to lay it on the line as we start to approach them. Yes, I heard him in the last round. Same exact one.
Well, that left hand has been there at times, not on that. The Black Beast gets hit by that leg kick. May not be a bad idea to start to check some of these.
Just
I'm not even sure the opponent saw it coming, so he'll see the replay and probably shake his head. But ultimately, this is a huge result and a huge win for that fighter here tonight. It is a heavyweight collision between Cain Velasquez and John Jones.
You ready? You ready?
Let's go, fight. Here we go. Round one is underway. Very compelling matchup for fight fans around the world. It's going to be very interesting to see how soon the first one goes.
He's going to try to get the takedown right away. But when he shoots that shot, he takes a step low. He is going to be shooting into a guy that truly understands all aspects of mixed martial arts. I'm wondering how, if his first shot doesn't work, does he approach trying to get this fight to the ground?
Both fighters pretty comfortable on the ground, DC, but you got to be very careful hanging out here for too long if you're his opponent. Right punches there, continues to apply pressure here in half guard. Bottom fighter trying to control posture, unable to do so.
And now he's in a lot of danger. He's got to grab that head or he's going to get blasted.
Escape, DC.
Oh, right to the mouth.
All right, so you gotta be careful playing on the ground with this guy. You don't want to mess around for too long. Under 3 minutes remain in round one. Well, he's staying pretty effective here, fighting off of his back. Nice strike landed there by the bottom by Jones. Strong bottom work here, staying busy. Side control now. We'll see if he can advance position. Velasquez has got him in a crucifix. Gonna work from the top now.
Start raining those elbows. Start raining those elbows.
All right, so he's sort of turtled up here. Not great body language. Perhaps he's trying to bait him in a little bit. Under 2 minutes now to go. From his opponent here, DC. He's curled up.
No, he's exhausted. He's been beaten.
Jones gets back up again. Nicely done. The future UFC Hall of Famer, the all-time great John Jones. Head kick there blocked by Cain Velasquez.
Big power punch land. Now we'll go back to range.
All right, so he's landed some good shots. You hate to be overly critical, but nothing really in terms of combinations.
Well, the jab has been looking great. How about jab, jab, right hand?
Right.
Because eventually, he's giving him so many different things right now.
That's what I'm talking about. Keep going again. Going again.
Oh! Jones' lower jaw now starting to show signs of struggle. Yeah, look at those apples.
What a fantastic strike.
do it. Oh, and he's able to land a strike there from the bottom. Nicely done by Cain Velasquez. Well, there are a few things more fun to watch in mixed martial arts than these type of transitions and scrambles on the ground.
High-level grappling can really be entertaining.
Some valuable separation.
And now the grounded pound starts.
Under a minute to go. Pretty good work with the grounded pound here by Velasquez. Oh, and now it's not the head. The referee has seen enough.
Mercifully.
The winner by TKO.
He mercifully stopped the fight. A great stoppage and a great performance by this young man.
Let's get you some replays now. Certainly a lot for our replay guys to work with in the truck. This was a clinic tonight in terms of mixed martial arts acumen in every round.
And once he got to the top, he started to land brutal ground and pound until the fight was called off. Just a dominant performance from the top position.
No. All right, so two truly elite strikers here. We sat down with them on Thursday and asked them any thoughts of taking this fight to the ground. They want to strike.
They want to strike. That's what got them to the show. That is the path that they are normally on. And tonight they get someone that allows them to fight in their comfort zone. They don't have to worry about defending takedowns. All they have to worry about is who can rely on their knowledge of the striking to carry them to victory.
With that right hand. Tried to go to the body, but unable to connect.
Beautiful kick.
Just over 2 minutes to go in round one.
You can really limit the mobility of your opponent with those leg kicks. Look at him working, trying to shut the liver down. Nice punch down.
Nice 1-2 there. Takedown there. How good is his takedown defense? So we cross the 32nd round in the opening round. He comes in the single collar tie. Takedown attempt late, and it's good. Oh, and he escapes up to his feet. Very nice. Lancer glancing right hand upstairs. Standing in that round, we'll see if his opponent can make the move.
Ready to fight? Ready.
All right, round two.
I mean, he's cutting down the side with these beautiful leg kicks. decides to attack, it is a sight to behold.
1-2 punches, two. He talks about his reach advantage off the top. Made good use of it there with that punch, DC.
Go back up, push forward.
Look at him chopping the wood. Chop the wood with those legs.
Whiffs on the right hand. Here looks like he may try to hit the scape.
Oh man, this ground and pound is good.
Probably my favorite striking realm in MMA, and he's as good as it gets.
The problem is, opponent is not controlling his posture. He's allowing his opponent to get up, and when he does, he creates this space to land a beautiful ground pound.
Oh, nice work from the bottom. Tags him with the punch. Oh, nice job using his strength there to posture up. We'll see what he can do.
He's gonna start looking to land big shots. Keep moving. Keep
moving. All right, so he's sort of turtled up here. Not great body language. Perhaps he's trying to bait him in a little bit. Posturing up now.
And now the damage is about to start.
Seconds to go in the round. Nice hammer fist.
He's putting him in exactly the position he needs to be in right now. He's able to relax here. And he understands, being a veteran of so many fights, that as long as he's on top, he's winning. He feels like he's winning here.
Take a seat. Listen, you're down on the scorecards. I need you to finish this fight this round. It has to happen. I need you to be a good
one. Right, let's take a look back at some of the replays from that last round.
Unbelievable to see these high-level competitors get in each other's face, tuck their chin, bite down on the mouth guard, and just let it all hang out over the course of 5 minutes.
You ready to fight? Ready.
Third and final round.
Big punch there.
Big power shot there. Well, he has landed some good shots, DC, but really unable to string anything together in terms of solid combinations.
It's because he's not committing to it fully. He throws it down. He may blow the right hand out there, but he's not really sitting down with the right hand. He really doesn't seem to have the intent on landing it. He's got to be confident that it's going to land. He's got to really throw his whole entire body into those strikes.
And he comes through the big knee.
Look at the commitment to kicking in this fight. Look at how he turns his foot into that leg.
Lands with a right hand. Oh, landed a beautiful straight punch there, DC. He's got an edge in reach and certainly is making it count this one. And he connects with a punch there. We'll see if there's more of that thing.
Boxing. 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 He's throwing bombs. Every time they come into contact, he is throwing bombs.
Shot to the body connects there. He hasn't really thrown too many body strikes in this fight, but now master of the transition. Nice grip. Visibly limping here. Trying to establish that jab once again. Oh, that's a beautiful kick right there. I don't know how this
works.
changes his stance.
Perfect execution on the strike that ultimately results in the KO here tonight.